Hello everyone, thank you for joining us again today for our learning series. We are learning how to use Figma as a product person to visually communicate our ideas. So Lauren is teaching us how to build a lightweight prototype in Figma. And we are here in lesson four. We've already created our file, we have structured that file, and then yesterday Lauren taught us all about libraries and how we can pull in all those amazing assets into our file. So today we're gonna go deep on components. And by deep, I mean we're gonna learn how to use them.
Light deep.
Does that seem feasible, Lauren?
Yeah, let's get into it. So let's pop back into the file that we used yesterday. So I'm going to go over here. I've started starring all of my files in my collaboration section so they're easy to find, like we talked about a couple of days ago. So let's pop into lesson three and we'll keep going from there. Okay, so let's start out with just like even what is a component? Why would you use a component? So the whole goal of components is to make it so that you have reusable elements that you can use over and over again. And let's start out with a simple, super simple component. So I'm going to start out and create a button because that's a pretty typical component. I'm going to create some text. I tap T on my keyboard to get text. And I'm going to say hello. And I'm going to put a frame around it here. Here's a super simple button we have here. So I'm going to go ahead and create this as a component. And to do that, I'm going to go up to the top navigation and hit this icon right here, create a component. And now I can grab that component a couple of different ways. In the file that I'm in, since I have this component right here with me, I'm just going to hold down option and drag, and that created an instance here. If I was in another file, I could grab it from my assets panel now because it's a component. So that's one reason we might want to have a component, is so that you can get pre-made things already. So in my assets panel on my left-hand side, it's called frame one. Let's give it a better name. Let's call it button. And now I can search for my button here in my assets panel. And it's this one right here. I can drag this in. Another way I can grab it is from my components up here. So if I go into resources and we have components as the first one, I search for button. Here's my button right here. So we can see I have three instances of this component. And going back to why would I even want this to be a component in the first place? On our main instance right here, we decided initially we wanted it to be a white background and black text. But what if our brand team comes to us and says, no, this can't be white. It actually needs to be black with white text and it needs to have rounded corners. If those weren't components, there's a couple ways you could change things all at once. It would involve either finding plugins or finding, you have to find them all to select them, first of all. But if it's a component, we can just change that on the main component and it'll change everywhere else. So if I were to go into here and say, nope, this is what I want to be white now, you can see it's automatically changing as I do this.
Whoa.
I want this to be black and I want some rounded corners on here as well. I'm going to change these over here. And these are automatically changing as I do that. So if you have something that is going to be duplicated more than one time, basically like a button or like a card or a lot of those elements that we have as components, it makes a lot of sense to make them components so that if you do need to make changes, you can do it just in one place. And then you can reuse them multiple times and publish them into libraries.
It's the terminology we're talking about here. The one we have on the left is our component. And then these other are instances of the component.
Exactly.
I think I heard. Is that right?
Exactly. Okay. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Great. And they will just automatically stay in sync as long as they're an instance of the component. Any updates to the component will be pushed to the instances.
Exactly. So you will find that if your main component is in a different file, say maybe your design team has created this file, that's where their library lives, and you are using these components from your assets panel. If they make a change, you'll get a little pop-up in the bottom corner over here that says, that's alerting you that changes have been made. You'll have to acknowledge that and bring those changes in. So this can be helpful if like you're in the middle of a design and you're not ready to bring in those changes yet. You can wait to hold those, but you can always bring those in later. But if you have something coming in from a different library, you will get a notification that something has changed. And if it's in the main file, like this one is, it'll update automatically.
Fantastic. Okay, great. So I imagine most of the time I'm just going to be using components that my designers probably have created. Mm-hmm. And we talked about pulling those in from the library. We talk about using those components in our file. So let's say we want to use one of our already made buttons in our iPhone frame below. Can we talk about how to do that?
Absolutely. So let's pull in, this one is from a different library. Let's pull in this button. And we had already talked about how we can change those instances right up here. So let's just pull in the instance that is shown right here. We want this one. And we can now add this to our designs wherever we want. We can, if it has been made as variants, so variants we talked about already a little bit are variations yep. of the component. We can change those on our right hand side. And we do have the option to change things outside of the variants. So say, for example, I change this to a different color and then I go ahead and I change the label. This is deviating from our components, so it might not be something we want to do, but if we're just playing around, that's definitely an option we have. And if we ever decided, oops, I didn't really mean to do this, or I really shouldn't have been playing with this, we can go over here into our instance options and yeah. drop down, and here's where we can either detach it. If you did mean to, like, if you really do want to start from, maybe you want to make your own button, but you need a place to start, that's a really good option of bringing in this button, then detach it, and then play from there. Or if you did want to go back to the original, you can reset all changes there. So when I reset it, that's taking us back to what we started with.
That makes sense. And so just to confirm, when I'm bringing in this instance, if I'm making those changes, it's not changing it for anybody else. It's not going to change it from a designer. I'm not going to get in trouble right. for doing that. Okay. Great. As long as it's the instance and not the original component itself.
Exactly. And there's no real way for you to bring in the original component. You can go back Great. To like, I can open up the, so here's, it says I'm hovering over this icon, go to main component library. I can go into that library. There's a good chance you're not going to be an editor on that library. So again, like a safety of, you don't have to worry about messing anything up.
Yeah.
But unless you literally Great. Like cut and paste you'd have to do to bring it into your file, you're not going to accidentally ruin somebody else's component there.
Okay, that makes sense. And is there any way to see like any kind of tips on how to use this or explanation of what this button is or anything like that?
Yeah, that's a great question. So we can look at component descriptions. That is going to be really helpful in understanding what the component is for. So if there is a description yeah. added, that's going to be right here where it says show more. I can see the full description. There's not a ton in this one. So let's find a component that does have a more full description. I think this button does. Yep, when I'm clicking on it, I can see a lot more information here. Let me drag this in just to see what it would look like in our file. Once this button's in our file, again, I see this show more option. I can look at all the details here. And this is great because now I understand what it's used for. So buttons are used to perform, et cetera, et cetera. I can see documentation's been added to here. So there's documentation link. It looks like there's brand guidelines in here. It looks like there's something about our design system button right here. A lot of information oh, wow. that I can gather just about the component when I am looking at it in this description here. Not all components will have a description. The designer will have to manually put that in. But to do that, let's pop over to our component we created over here. If I wanted to add a description, and what I would do is go over to my right-hand side where it says button, that's the name of my component. Right next to it is an icon component configuration, and I can go into yeah. there, and this is where I can add in my information. So this is, I can add all sorts okay. of information. And this to me is super helpful because you can not only just add description about what it is, but if there's aliases that like maybe this is known by something else. So an example that I always like to use is a heart icon. I don't know if it's called heart, like, love, favorite. There's a lot of words that it could be. And unless I know the exact word, I am not going to be able to find it in my assets panel. But if I have all of those words in the description, so for example, we'll search for our button. And we'll find our button. That's our first button right here. But if I searched for just, I'm going to search for heart because obviously this button isn't showing up when I search for heart. But if I do in the description, write heart, and then I go ahead and search for heart again, now our button's showing up because that word is in the description. So it's really helpful for discoverability of your components when you have that information in the description there.
That makes a lot of sense. And also to be able to find things that are relevant that my designer might have created but have titled something else, just being able to search for that like we did in our library before. That's great. Mm-hmm. And then the last thing I don't think we've touched on yet for components, we talked about it last time, but I'd love to just resurface that here is the variance of like how to switch between the different options when you have bring that component in and want to maybe switch it to a different style.
Yeah, totally. Variants again are those variations of a component. So let's just super quickly make one variation to show how we would do that
oh, cool.
and where we would find it.
Okay.
So if say I have this black button here, but say I wanted, it's my primary button, but say I wanted a secondary button and that one is purple. What I would do so that I can see those options like we saw on this right hand side to be able to switch easily in between. When I have my component right here, up now where we initially made it a component, it says add variant. So if I click on that and I add a variant, now I can see I have these options of, and I called it, or I have, you, we can see my description here. That's why it says heart. But I have these options now to change what the variants are called. So we're going to call this one is our default, great. And this one, we're just going to double click into here and call this, let's actually call this our secondary. And we'll call our first one our primary. And we're just going to change the color on this and we'll make it that. Here, we'll grab this purple. And now when I am just holding down option to pull one of these out, I have the option to switch between primary and secondary. And I have those properties here. It's just called property right now, but again, we can double click on this and decide what we want to call it. So this would be our type of button. So now when I'm over here, I'm seeing, okay, this is the type of button. I just want to switch between primary and secondary. Your designers, if we look back at our one that has a bunch of different variants and component properties in here, we might have the option to just switch between a couple, but we also might have the option to turn something on or off.
And there cool.
Yeah, and there might even be an option to change the label right within this side properties right here. I don't have to click in to change it. So a lot of different properties and variants that you can see from here and just play around with and change those right from your side panel and not have to dig in to change those things or manually change color and stuff like that.
This is so helpful because it just gave me this aha moment. When I see things in FigJam that have different variants, I now understand how to create those. Yes. They would be a component with different variants, right?
Exactly. Yeah. And that's actually a super fun call out because when you create these libraries and you publish these libraries, you can pull in a library that you've made in Figma in FigJams and use them as like stickers technically. So you, all of these variants that you've created, you can swap between those variants in FigJam. So you can pull a library from one place to another, which is really fun.
That's so great. So I just copied our button that you just created, our hello button, into our FigJam file. So we can see that there's those little variants there. And that feels so powerful because I always felt like this is something that has to be something a designer has created for us, but we've created that button there and now it has the variant. That's so cool. So now I know how to do that.
Yes. Exciting.
That's incredible.
That's awesome. Yep. And then just right here, this is how she was able to change those variants. We see that same symbol there and she can swap between those because she's just pulled this right into FigJam.
That's incredible.
Yes.
We're doing it, Lauren. So we've talked about components. We talked about how to interact with them, how to find that description and documentation and how that's powerful for discoverability. We talked about that if you're working with an instance of the component, it won't change the original. And then also how to create our components, how to detach the original instance, and then how to edit them once you have them on the file. I think we've covered it all.
Yes, amazing. And variants are like a pretty deep topic too. So one thing I like to call out for folks is that if you want to learn a little bit more of those, search in our Figma Help Center about variants and component properties too, because that'll allow you to get really deep into those. But I think for what we need, just being able to figure out how to add those additional variants is still so super powerful.
So powerful. Yeah, I feel like I have what I need now to start adding buttons, start adding all of these different components into our frame, and then understand even how to create some of those for power up my Figma files too.
Absolutely.
Bonus.
Yes.
Awesome. Well, thank you, Lauren, so much for covering components today. We'll be back tomorrow to talk about styles and variables.
Yes.
Different from variants. Looking forward to that.
Yes. Amazing.
See you soon.
Bye.